Summertime.
Live from the Marina Del Rey condo HOA common area. Welcome to Comedy Bang Bang. We're here for Marissa Wampler's 17th birthday party.
Womp it up!
I have here Marissa Wampler. The sun is shining. It is August 12th. This is your birthday proper?
No, my birthday was 2 days ago, but...
On the 10th.
Yeah, but we decided to throw it on a Monday.
Great.
Yeah, just to really get people... Because I wanted them to have the weekend to relax.
Sure.
So they can really whop it up on a Monday.
Of course, you need... that's... Why have a birthday party the day after you're all stressed out from school?
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
And
like,
you really want to cut loose. No, repress that urge. Yeah. Sleep it off.
Relax for a couple of days, and then you're ready to womp it.
Exactly. Monday is hump day.
Yeah, welcome to the show. My name is Scott Aukerman, and this is Comedy Bang Bang, and we're here. This is sort of an atypical show, as you can tell from the noise behind us. We are here at a condo common area pool.
Yes.
We're on top of a sort of makeshift jerry-rigged structure.
Doesn't feel very sound.
No.
Doesn't feel very structurally sound.
I don't want anyone to worry about their safety.
I am very worried.
Speaking of safety, the woman who's endangering us right now, you just heard her, Miss Listler.
Aukerman?
Listler, I should say.
Happy birthday, Marissa.
Oh, thank you, Miss Listler.
You're a star and a treasure.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. Well, thank you for building this structure for us to sit upon.
You're welcome. Don't step there.
Be careful.
Sorry, I stepped into a little, it feels like a pothole, but it's
be
like
careful.
A sinkhole.
It's a tiny mini tramp.
Most of this has been...
Trampoline?
If you want to just bounce on one ankle, go for it.
Kind of hurt.
At your own risk, though.
I'm going to re-break this foot. So, Marissa, for the uninitiated, for maybe people who just started listening to the show, maybe they saw the TV show recently and have come over, let's explain you just a little bit, very, very briefly, because there's not enough time. We would take the whole hour to explain
sure
your
would.
Entire story.
Our history's been long and varied.
You were my intern back at the old radio station where we used to tape this.
Right.
You never showed up.
Nope.
The first day you did, you hopped on mic immediately.
Threw on the cans. And America started hearing these dulcet tones, and they wanted to hear more.
Well, I don't know about that. And then you promptly abandoned the show for several months.
For about 8 or 9 months.
And you come in every 3 months or so.
Yeah, just to check in. That was when we started. That was the summer before my freshman year. I am now entering my junior year. If you can believe it,
I actually passed
sophomore year.
Yeah.
I had to take it twice.
And you and Listler here is your teacher. You're in the STARS program at your high school.
Yes, I'm at an
unofficial teacher.
In an advanced learning program, a special program.
There's some controversy about that, whether it's advanced or whether...
It's called the STARS program, and it no longer actually occurs during school hours.
Right, because Listler was arrested and incarcerated for a brief time, and then we got her out, and we decided to do more of an independent study.
That's right.
The hours of 5:30 a.m. till 9, and then again from 3... sometimes till 11 or 12 at night.
I think a good public school starts at 9. That's a civilized hour.
Oh, yeah. Marina Del Rey, we keep this shit real.
She doesn't go to homeroom. I don't want anyone to be able to track her.
Yeah.
Okay, so that briefly covers what's going on here, and you have an interesting family life and friends. And the last time you were on the show, we said that on your birthday, we would broadcast live from your pool party, and here we are.
I have never had a pool. This is my first party that I've ever thrown in my entire life, if you could believe. I have never had a sleepover. Well, I'm not counting the ones I have with Listler.
In my trundle.
Twice or three times a week. But I've never had a party before, and I put out the APB.
All points bulletin.
I said, hey, listen, you know, I'm having this party. I made up a flyer.
She got out her Word doc.
I got out
some clip art.
Clip art. I did a Chili Willy clip art.
Yeah, I noticed that you actually clip arted like some scissors.
Yeah.
Like, those are the things that you normally clip with.
Yeah.
You put them on the flyer.
I'm learning.
Are there scissors at this party?
There might be. It might be a giveaway at the end.
Okay.
Everyone goes away with their own safety scissors. That was Lister's idea.
Everyone needs safety scissors.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Too many of my friends have died using really sharp scissors.
I've noticed there's a box of safety scissors here. They're all left-handers, too. Are you left-handed, Lister?
Absolutely.
I've never noticed that about
you. I'm actually ambidextrous. I can use my feet, too.
Oh, my God.
Like my left foot.
By the way, Lister was in the Army during the Iraqi war.
She was a sniper.
Did you shoot with either hand?
Yeah, absolutely. You had to be able to roll over and shoot with anything.
She showed us the other day that she could put a pistol in between her tits, and she could shoot pretty much a bullseye from them.
Just squeezing them together, that pulls the trigger?
When you work up your pecs into such a hard state.
Yeah, those are monsters.
I could control my nipple to pull the trigger.
Oh, my goodness. Wow.
Her nipples, by the way, look like Yoda's fingers. Do you know what I mean? Those three figures that Yoda has?
She's never seen them. I've only described them to
her. But that's what she describes.
I didn't want to be inappropriate.
Okay, sure.
Long and scaly.
Now, your body, I've never... what are you wearing right now? I've never quite seen you in something like this before.
I am wearing a tankini top.
Yeah.
With Adidas track pants on the bottom.
Yeah.
Now, those are in an extra large because, as you know, I'm shaped...
Like a pear, an upside-down pyramid.
Yeah, or someone described an upside-down muffin.
Right.
But I decided to, with Listler's help, we went over to the Big and Tall store, and we decided to, we got our tankini top was on clearance. Is that right?
That's an extra small.
Yeah, that's an extra small.
And then the bottoms are for big and tall people who are about 6'10", it looks
exactly.
like.
Exactly. These are like what Channing Tatum wore in Step Up to the Streets.
Yeah. Those are like the pants that Bruce Banner wears because he's going to change into the Hulk at any moment.
And he's going to rip apart.
Yeah.
Exactly. So that's a bit of mystery. There's mystery on top and there's mystery on bottom.
No, I can see. Yeah. It seems to me like you should be wearing a swimsuit of some sort. We're at a pool.
Yeah.
Well, that's what a tankini is, Ackerman, if you never heard of
fashion. No, but I mean on the bottom.
Well,
she could still cannonball.
I can still cannonball, and I will. But I really wanted, and who knows what I got underneath here? I may have nothing. We don't know.
We don't. You do, hopefully.
I do.
Yeah.
But we'll see what happens if I get a couple of Mai Tais in me.
We should be clear. There's no drinking at this party, is there?
It's virgin Mai Tais.
Virgin Mai Tais. Seth is mixing them over by the burgers.
Right. Seth is your stepfather. Seth, what is his last name, by the way?
Wampler. He actually he changed his name.
He took your mother's name in marriage?
Which is weird because it's actually my mom's... name that she took in marriage.
In her first husband.
In her first husband.
Wow.
But he liked it so much. So he's now Dr. Seth Wampler. And,
what is he a doctor of again? I can't remember.
He does orthopedic surgery.
Right.
But
right,
only
on feet, though, right?
On feet. Is that what a pediatric? I don't know what.
Yeah,
podiatrist,
I think that's what orthopedic is. Isn't
but
it?
He only works on certain types of people. I think it's...
people with narrow feet or with...
No, it's how attractive they are.
Oh,
yeah.
I see.
He only works on very attractive
Interesting.
People.
And he's here at the party. He's mixing up some stuff, so we'll be talking to him a little bit later. Who else is at this party that we've talked to or spoken to? By the way, if you haven't heard the Christmas Womptacular, that wasn't an official Comedy Bang Bang episode. That's in the Earwolf Presents file. Go, please listen to that. That's where we talk about where we met a lot of these people.
Oh, yeah.
Including your old friend Eric Gutterballs Gutterman, right?
Well, Gutterballs is currently here. In fact, why don't we invite him up? Is it too
is
soon?
Is he? Really?
Yeah, he's here. I have a big announcement to make America's going to want to know about.
God, we got to get to this then before the... should we tease it or... I don't know. Whatever happens, happens.
You know
happens,
what?
I
think we should let it happen and then let's see what evolves.
Where is he? Can you call him
Hey,
out?
Gutters! Gutters!
Oh, he's down below. Hey, Gutters!
Gutters!
What?
Hey, come up here, would you?
Huh?
Climb the rope ladder.
He's been doing his scuba training while the party's happening.
let's put that scuba training to good use here.
Hey, buddy, be careful with your asthma under there. Do you need your inhaler? Oh, God.
Hey, welcome to the show.
Hey.
Jason, I mean, Eric. Eric is your name, obviously.
We call him Gutterman.
Gutterballs, yeah.
Have you been spiking your Mai Tais, Chalk Talk? Come on.
I may
now.
Have brought in a little something for myself. This is, I mean, I haven't been around this many children in.
Ew. Oh, since when? You got the court order that you're not allowed? That's not
That's
funny,
not
man.
That's not true. That is not true, and that is not funny.
Okay.
And it's not something
not
we're
funny.
Joking about.
No.
I'm just saying that I don't usually go to 16-year-old.
Well, that's good to know.
Or 17-year-old now.
That's good to 17.
Getting warmer.
Sweet 17.
Are you going to let him speak? He's been
standing
here.
Yeah, Gutters. So, Gutters, tell everybody who you went to the prom with this year.
Who I went with or who I was supposed to go with?
You know what, man? This is exactly what we've been working on in couples counseling, right?
Yeah.
You undercut it. You're afraid to feel and to heal.
Wait, what is the story?
Wait, it's two different in order people? To deflect.
Fine, tell the story.
It's two different people, Eric?
Who are you supposed to go with?
Stacey McNichol.
And what happened? She got shingles.
She got shingles. Or at least that's what she said.
That's herpes in your spine.
Mm-hmm. Shingles
is herpes in your spine.
Oh.
We found that out on the Comedy Bang Bang TV show, the Seth Rogen episode.
Oh, God.
He got shingles.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Do you get it sexually? Does someone have to your spine in order to get it?
Oh, please, Marissa.
Marissa.
Woohoo! Wop it up!
My Language.
Okay, so Stacey McNichol gets shingles.
Yeah.
How soon before the prom?
I don't know, like a week, she said. She told me like a week before. I don't know. I saw her out with her family. She looked okay.
You can't normally see shingles.
Yeah, they're in your spine. So.
Oh, okay.
But that is true. Her whole family had shingles.
How do you know about the McNichols family?
I watch everyone.
All right. At any rate, so Stacey McNichols falls ill, and you don't want to take anybody in a wheelchair to the prom. That was one of your things.
Had you rented
Yeah, that was the only option. The only option of somebody left.
Is that she go
was
on
that
wheels.
What?
Is that she go on
she
wheels?
She goes meals on wheels, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What, had you rented a tuxedo at this point?
Oh, yeah, my mom took me to get a tuxedo.
And the deposit is non-returnable.
Oh, no, and it was all my paper route money.
Yeah, oh, you still have a paper route.
Oh, yeah, that's how I make money.
Do you drive around with it, or are you on the bike?
I drive around on my bike.
Oh, okay. You ride on your bike.
Yeah, I mean, like, I mean... What? Yeah, sure.
What square?
I do have a driver's license.
Sure.
I don't want to make it sound like I can't drive. I can drive.
You choose to do it on your bike, though.
Right.
Because it's easier to throw.
I don't have a car.
Oh, I see. Okay.
I can drive.
What paper?
The Marina Del Rey Chronicle.
The Chronicle. Oh, okay. Yeah. That's a reputable institution.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. So you had already rented a tux.
It's going out of business, though.
Oh, so what happens to you then?
You know, a lot of us are really struggling now.
Print is
a lot
dead,
of
yeah.
us. It's like
paper
you're
boys.
Come on, man. But you don't have like a mortgage or mouths to feed. It's like
well,
big
I
deal.
Do, I help my parents out.
Okay.
Maybe you could deliver the e-version of the paper to people's computers via email.
Like wirelessly?
Yeah, you could like press send on the email, like do just a BCC email to people.
I think you're kidding.
You can edit the patch.
You don't know. You have to ask if he's kidding, because sometimes his humor is so subtle, you just don't know.
If you want to edit the patch, the Marina
not
Day...
Almost not. Almost not existed.
I can't say it. Marina Del Rey patch, you can... I'll give you duties of that.
What's this?
The Marina Del Rey patch.
What
is
that?
A paper?
Like a lesbian
it's like
rack?
A community... It's a...
Community paper?
Marissa?
I'm asking. It sounds like a lesbian rag, like a
well, you know,
like where you print lesbian news.
Marissa, you know everybody calls it the snatch, right?
the
snatch. Everybody calls it the snatch.
That's fine. Every town has a snatch, then.
No, every town has a lot of snatches.
All right,
Eric.
We devolve.
Eric, come on.
What?
All right, so tell us the story.
Okay,
you're
so anyway,
all of a sudden.
McNichols. So then
she's
you,
out.
You tell her she's out.
Right.
I have been keeping my options open. As you know, I had...
Last time you were on Comedy Bang Bang proper, we had a contest for listeners to write you songs to take you to the prom.
Right, and
what
I had
happened?
Chosen a gentleman who... Listler will attest to this. Mm-hmm, he had skin like the underside of a baby
he was
chick.
Very handsome.
Soft skin. He
dimply?
Was dimply. It was. He
probably,
was Australian.
A fake picture. Mm-hmm. Probably
no,
a fake picture.
No, actually, it was a moving picture. It was a video. He wrote a song for me. That's how romantic this man is.
Mm-hmm. Although it's CGI
it.
These
we
days.
We need to make that available to people. Does everyone have availability to that?
We got
to
get
yeah, we'll
that
post
on
it.
The World
go,
Wide
to the,
Web.
Go to the show page. We'll post it somehow.
All right.
Yeah.
So I chose him. Then there were visa issues.
Oh,
okay,
he doesn't have a credit card.
He doesn't have a credit card,
not
so he couldn't pay
visa.
For the. He was joking again. Let him know. Just give him a heads up.
Okay, anytime I say a joke, I'll give you a thumbs up, okay?
Yeah. Cool.
How's that sound?
At any rate, so I was without a date. So this guy shows up at my window at about 2 a.m.
Wow.
Are
you on the second floor or are you on the first floor?
I'm on the first floor. As you know, I sleep in what is kind of just a crawl space.
Oh, that's right.
And there's actually no window into her crawl space.
How many floors is your condo here?
It's two floors. I sleep in, there's a crawl space within the great room that I'm being forced to sleep in.
Oh,
even
okay.
though there is a room, my bedroom is now filled with baby stuff from their baby shower.
So did you show up at the patio door? Is that like the sliding glass door? Is that where
you are? No, I showed up in the side yard.
Oh, okay.
Because that's where the window looks out.
Oh, okay.
Right.
But
So I was sleeping on my arrow bed, which has a hole in it. So mid about 2 or 3 a.m., I got to pump it back up again.
Okay, so about 2 a.m., you're up anyway.
Yeah, I'm up pumping, and I hear...
That's usually when I get texts from her.
Yeah, and I hear...
They always start them pumping it up.
Yeah. And so I hear Robin Thicke's Blurred Lines being
played. Oh, that's
played.
A sexy song.
And I don't know where it's coming from, so I look out, and there he is, like Say Anything style, holding a boombox over his head, playing that song.
Now, is this a boombox with a CD player, a tape player?
No, it's my dad's old boombox.
So you transferred the song onto a
No,
tape?
It was just on the radio.
I thought that song... That's good, because I always feel like that song's sort of loosely about rape.
Yeah, so it just happened to be the song that was playing.
That's actually very comforting to me to know that you didn't choose that.
No, I was out there for a while just playing the radio. I think you noticed it when it was that song.
Got it. Okay. At any rate.
Wait, were you aiming it at her?
Oh, no, it was for her.
Oh, okay.
It was for her, but I'm just saying I didn't choose that song specifically.
What were the songs that played before it, the one that you were hoping she would wake up
to? Oh, there's the one that goes, I got that good kush and alcohol.
Oh, did you have some
I'm
kush and alcohol?
I'm a ball till the day I fall. That one played for a while. I was hoping she wouldn't notice that one.
Okay.
Just because I don't know what it's about.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So at any rate, I go outside. He says, listen, you know, I don't want to...
That's how you start off with nice romantic gestures. Yeah. Hey, listen.
He goes, hey, listen, I don't want to take this handicapped girl to the prom anymore. So would you want to go as friends? And I thought, why not? You know what I mean?
Well, you thought about all the couples counseling that we've been doing together.
You guys used to date... Right? We talked about this before.
She doesn't like to call it dating.
We use date very loosely.
But you, and not to be indelicate here, but we've talked about it on the show. You guys scissored.
We scissored fully
clothed.
Pants
on scissoring.
Yeah.
On the gymnastics mats.
Right.
I just want to throw out there, if anyone were to scissor me tonight, this Adidas tracksuit pant has got a real sheen to it.
Yeah,
so there's
it's
not
like
going to be
nylon-y, like,
yeah.
It's making a lot of noise when you
it's
walk.
It's making a lot of noise, and we could make a lot of noise later is what I'm saying. Wop it up!
All right, and Eric, you're wearing a swimsuit, so you're wearing like a
jams.
Kind of a, yeah,
I'm wearing what?
Old school jams.
Old school jams.
Yeah. What are those?
Yeah.
Like board shorts.
I'm wearing a pair of my dad's old jams.
Oh, okay, great. Yeah.
I guess I don't know. I guess they were super popular in like the '80s and maybe early '90s. I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure they're not a current label.
So how did the prom go? I mean, everyone wants to hear about this. I mean, or is this too long of a story? Do we need to... Listler, you're keeping time, right?
That's absolutely right.
Yeah, okay. Well, you'll let us know when we need to take a break. So,
okay.
So
long
what
story short, she said, yes, she would go, but seemed to indicate that she wanted it to be like maybe like a real thing and not just friends.
Well,
and how did you feel about that?
I was surprised.
Hmm.
Okay, by real thing, I just meant I would like you to show up on time.
Right,
to pick
and you
me
said,
up.
But no, you said
Could
you wanted
I ask
to slow
you
dance.
How long?
You wanted to slow
how
dance.
How late were you?
I was 45 minutes. I was an hour late.
You were 2.5 hours late.
2.5 hours late.
Why would you be 2.5 hours late?
2.5 hours late.
Well, I mean,
I guess there's a backup at the tuxedo store.
It's a long story, but my mom said she was going to pick up my tuxedo, and she didn't.
Oh.
So I had to ride my bike to the tuxedo store.
Oh, no. And then did you put it in your paper route bag?
Yeah.
With all the papers?
That it was all wrinkled.
Newsprint all over it?
When I got back and I took a shower.
It was a white tuxedo, too.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah.
Were some of the headlines on it, like Play-Doh?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. What was the headline that was on the back of this tuxedo?
May 23rd. What was happening May 23rd?
Wiener strikes again.
Yeah.
Oh.
No, it wasn't that. May 23rd.
Oh, that was a joke. Okay.
Just let people know. Everyone, even America should know when a joke is coming.
Okay.
Or has come. But at any rate, so we rode to the bike. We rode to the prom on your bike.
Yep.
I had several pounds of hair extensions put into my hair because I have alopecia, which is something I don't know if I ever mentioned.
We've never talked about that.
I have a tremendous amount of hair around my nipples.
Yeah, no, we've seen that.
As much hair
is
growing.
You showed Judd Apatow
that,
I believe.
Yeah, yeah. He hasn't called. That's weird.
Yeah, weird.
Yeah, it's weird. Uh-huh. But as much hair as I have there, I'm losing it on my head. So Listler actually put in, I don't know, where did you even find these extensions, Shardog?
Beauty 35.
What is that?
It's a store in New York City. I have a friend that lives above it, and I asked her to send me some weave.
Yeah, so a lot of it was African-American hair, so...
Which actually comes from Indians.
Does it?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's intended for African-Americans, but they take the hair out of Indian women.
Like Native Americans?
No.
Cool.
So, are you on the handlebars of this bike, or what are you...
He actually has a sidecar that usually his mini schnauzer rides in.
Okay. So how do you fit in it with...
Not well.
Yeah, with your
situation. So it took us a lot longer
to get
to the prom.
She's also allergic to the fur.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty much now covers the sidecar.
Because I've always described you as sort of a maxi schnauzer.
Yeah, thanks. I appreciate that.
Have you tried putting like Propecia or Rogaine on your head?
Or Boniva?
That's for weak bones.
Oh. I don't think that's right.
If Sally Field sells it, I'm buying it.
Really? No matter what it is?
Absolutely.
You love Brothers and Sisters? A big fan of that show?
Never watched it.
Oh, my gosh.
Is she selling something on that show?
Well, the commercial space
I'm not
within
interested,
it.
Well, I think, listen, do you feel like she's not really Sally Field on that show? She's a different character?
She must be.
What about Lincoln? Did you watch Lincoln?
I didn't.
No,
is that
just any ad she makes? Is that she plays Mary?
She's selling
Mary
Lincoln
Todd.
Town cars.
No, she's although that would have been a great tie-in.
Could you hold on one second?
What's
hold
going
on one second? Oh my God!
What?
How did she get in here?
What is happening?
Danielle Bartiromo's here.
Danielle
Bartiromo. I have to go for one second.
Okay.
I will be back.
Take this.
I will
take
be back.
This microphone. Or should we go to break?
I'm freaking out right now.
Should we go to break?
We're going to break. I'm gonna cut a bitch.
Okay, well, I guess we're going to break. Come on back. We'll have more Comedy Bang Bang live from Marissa Wampler's 17th birthday party at the Marina Del Rey Condo HOA Common Room. Come on back after this. Common area.
Wop it up. I'm going to cut a bitch. Wop it up.
Hey, welcome back to Comedy Bang Bang. Scott Aukerman here. We're here with Marissa Wampler and Listler, and we are high above the pool at the Marina Del Rey condo common area pool party. A lot of kids frolicking, I guess is what you would call it.
Yeah, well, there's a lot more here than there were before the break.
Yeah, what happened? It was a manageable size right before the break.
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden you said...
Yeah, I'm going to cut a bitch is what I said.
Danielle was here.
Yeah, I have I've dragged Danielle up onto the platform because I'd like her to talk to me about why she's here.
Oh, this is Danielle. Oh, my
And
goodness.
Why she brought her almost entirely Asian crew with her.
Oh, look at those.
Of 44 people.
Oh, my God, look at
those.
I was
trying
those
to make your party better.
Okay, well, you ruined it. First of all, how did you jump the fence with tits that big is my first question.
I have to say, those are amazing.
Thank you.
I've heard stories about it. This is our first time. Hi, Scott Aukerman.
Dale, don't nice touch her. To don't you dare touch her.
Sorry, but it's impressive. It's like going to see the Grand Canyon. It's just
you have to
sit and admire it.
You
for
know
a
what?
Should.
You know what, man? I will call the cops on you.
How old are you, Danielle?
I am 16 and a half.
Okay, so
watch it. But I got my boobs at 9.
Whoa, okay.
Yeah, when we were in...
That's a good 7.5 years.
Second grade, was it second or third grade that you got your period?
It was second. It was the beginning of second, but then I just spotted for a while.
Okay.
God.
In like second grade, she would just raise her hand and she'd be like, oh, I got an OB tampon. I got to use it. I've been spotting and tell everybody. And then
I like the OB ones better because you can insert them yourself.
You know what?
Yeah,
just
Obi-Wan.
Shut up. I cannot believe
Help me,
you're
Obi-Wan.
Here. I cannot believe you're here right now.
You're just jealous because I look better than you do in your tankini.
Okay. First of all, your body be banging. Nobody Nobody is ever gonna.
I'm not gonna argue that.
Gonna argue that.
I think that would be a silly argument.
You'd be an idiot if you argued.
You would be an idiot.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
you should be in Maxim now. You should because that shit's gonna fade. That's what my mom said.
No, my mom still looks really, really good.
Some would say that you've been a woman for so long, it's almost like you're not 16 and a half. It's almost like...
You know what? Don't try to justify it for yourself.
It's still illegal.
God.
No, it's still illegal.
It's 100% illegal.
I have the body awareness of like a 45-year-old.
Yeah, yeah.
What does that mean, the body awareness?
I'm just very in touch with my body.
God.
I've been with it for a long time.
You know what, man? Yeah. Here's the deal. I did not invite you, and I did not invite your Asian crew. And
yeah,
so
what
I
is
don't
up
know.
With the, all the, the all is of this, a sudden it's like
roles?
It's like UCLA just got out or something.
Is it Quest Crew from Best Dance Crew Ever?
They do dance. They do dance. And you know what? I like to hang with a shorter crew because it makes me feel a little taller.
Ah, yeah, because how tall are you? Can I?
I'm 4'9 and a half.
Yeah, that's adding to it. So
adding to what?
Just the proportion.
Ew, I am so grossed out and enraged.
I'm sorry.
Now.
Okay, I've heard a lot about Danielle here, and it's D apostrophe. How do you spell your name?
Well, it's Danielle, but it's Danielle.
Oh, I see. Okay, great.
That's how you pronounce it.
So what is the deal here? You brought you.
Well,
you're
you
not
weren't
invited.
You weren't invited.
I am making your party better.
I don't need your charity, all right? Nobody asked you to come, and I know exactly why you're here, and that's to get Gutterballs back.
Now, you used to date Eric.
We did.
Yeah. And what happened?
You know, I scissored him while you were dating, right?
That's what you told the school, yes.
Well, that's what he told us as well on this program.
Yeah, two scissors make a right.
Or, in the case of these safety scissors, a left.
Exactly. And by the way,
joke,
I am going to kick you out, so take a safety scissors on your way out. You might need it to cut your own pubes or something.
What? Oh, Marissa?
I actually think that's why you're wearing those pants. I saw her once in the locker room, and it was like her thighs had sideburns.
All right, you know what? You know what?
Do you have Elvis Presley thighs?
Yes.
She's got Elvis Presley thighs. Good song.
It's a great song.
So, Danielle, what happened with Eric? Tell us about this, because I know a little bit about it, but tell the listeners who don't know what's going on here. You dated?
Okay. We were dating, and then I found out that he had scissored Wampler, which I let go, and then I started dating Mikey Piscatola, a college guy.
Who has a bed in the back of a van.
He does.
Really?
That has the spray-painted wolf on the side of it.
Oh, so he's cool.
He's awesome, and it's a waterbed.
He's also dying of about 700 STDs.
It's fine. It's fine. I may have caught some, but that doesn't stop me from motorboating, or I can do anything below the
motorboating.
Pants.
Motorboating means what? Going out on the water? The antibiotics don't stop you from going out on the water?
No, if someone wanted to put their head in between my gigantic boobs, then they're not going to get an STD from that.
This is a classy podcast. It always has been.
Really?
And she's bringing it in and just taking it down to a really trashy level, and I'm not interested.
I don't mind. I'm interested.
You know what?
We'll
talk
about this.
God.
Danielle, you need to get tested.
I guess I do, but I am also told that as long as I use a dental dam or as long as there's a glove involved, if I'm getting finger blasted, then
glove?
I'm fine.
Oh, what kind of STDs does he have on his fingers?
That's in order to not send them to other people.
Yes.
Communicate the diseases.
Although
you could have
a cut on your hand. We should be responsible anytime there's any kind of contact in there.
Wrap
it up.
What about your childbearing years?
Are you thinking about that?
Because some of these diseases can make you infertile.
I don't know if I'm infertile because I've been pregnant a lot.
Why are you talking to her? Why do you care about her sexual health?
Who is this
woman?
Hold on.
Well, this is Listler. You've not seen Listler around the school?
Why would she have seen
me? Is that weird woman who hides in lockers?
She did it. She slept in a locker for 2.5 weeks.
I've also built a secret system of connecting hallways through the back of lockers.
Like the Rats of Nim. Or Watership Down.
Marissa,
It's like a rabbit warren within the halls of the school so that I can come and go as I please and keep my eyes on you.
I think
she
gave me a pink slip once for running in the hall. She said I was going to injure myself.
Yeah, because your tits are so big.
Marissa, I feel like you're bearing the lead. Come here for a second.
What? Yeah.
She said that she's been pregnant a lot.
What?
She just admitted
it. I didn't hear that. I was too busy screaming into the microphone.
I know. You have to
I don't hear
calm
what anybody else is saying.
I know. This is part
I don't
of
even know where
Look,
I am right
we
now.
We can talk about your broadcasting skills later. What I need to talk to you
like
about
now. I feel like I just experienced lost time, like when an alien takes you and then puts you back on the Earth, and you say, "What happened to those 2.5 hours?" Yes.
Right. Well, we got to talk about that another time. But what we have to talk about right now is the fact that she said she's been pregnant a lot, and Eric, she used to date Eric.
Oh my God!
Hold on, we need to talk to her about this.
Okay, let's
go back and talk
to her.
Do you want to interrogate her, or do you want to play good cop, bad cop? Or
don't. Is this kind of a sexual thing for you? Like you want to be bad cop with her? Because I'm not really interested in playing into that.
But I'll play good cop too. I'm into either.
Okay, let's just go back and talk to her.
So this is a salve that I think you might want to try.
Stop giving her salves! I just knocked that salve in the pool.
Danielle.
I can swim down there and get it back into her hands.
I'd love to see that.
She has gills. You know that she had gills installed along with all of her jelly
patches. She makes
patches.
A weird noise when she dives into a pool. Like, yeah. You know, it's like...
She spent time with the Navy SEALs.
I wonder when she shoots a gun, does she go pow pow?
Yeah, she does.
Interesting.
She does.
Danielle.
Hey, Danielle.
Hey.
So we want to talk to you about something that you mentioned just a second ago.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is it about my period at age 9 again?
No, it's about times when you maybe wouldn't have gotten your period, like when you were pregnant, maybe with Eric Gutterball's baby.
We don't know.
Why? Because you never had sex?
Well,
oh my God, you never had sex.
What do you count as sex?
I count it if he stuck his mechanical pencil inside of the gaping hole that is your vagina.
Eric, there was other holes that he stuck it in, but it was never in there. He said that.
Which
holes? Your ear holes or
your eyes are kind of an orifice?
There were just other holes. He just said that he just wasn't ready for that. So he kind of just,
I knew it.
Like,
did he ever say, can I pick your nose with this mechanical pencil?
There were times where he just said, any hole will do except for that one. He kind of just like rub it around.
Is that a song from Jesus Christ Superstar?
Any hole will do.
Any hole will do.
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay, well, he lied to me. He lied to me. Joseph in the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat, yeah. Any hole will do.
Yeah.
He lied to me. He told me that he had sexual intercourse with you. So that is great information. It's good information to know that you never had his baby inside of you.
But you don't know if he's the father of one of your...
Well, because one time he got excited and like went on the periphery, and I don't know if
it can swim through jeans. Shardoff?
Absolutely.
Oh, you're back.
How thick were your jeans?
Oh, gosh, you're back. You got that thing with you?
Yeah, she in her teeth.
Oh, my gosh.
She's like one of those Navy trained dolphins.
Oh, God, I've never seen the like. So, yeah, so wait. He was just kind of outside of it, and then it just kind of...
Yeah, and so, like, a little may have gotten inside, and then...
It's like blood spatter on CSI.
Exactly.
Just, yeah, okay.
God. Exactly. And MTV, they wanted to do, like, I had auditioned for their teen pregnancy show.
Before you were even pregnant?
Well, no, like, from that. When
got
pregnant.
The minute you learned the news, you went over to the MTV.
I submitted an application.
That's smart. Yeah. Capitalize.
But you didn't get it, and that's why you
It was, like, down to the wire. It was really down to the wire.
Okay, yeah. That's, you know, I mean, MTV really ought to think about that. They, you know, I mean, they're the leading cause of people terminating
their
pregnancies.
It's true, wanting just to get on.
It's really true.
Yeah. So then,
and not getting on.
I would have gone through with it.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, okay. Okay. It's a lot of information right now.
Okay, but there is no baby.
I'm going to take a sip of my Virgin Mai Tai right now and just try to calm down. Listen, I would like you and your Asian crew to leave immediately.
Why? I am making your party better.
No, you're not.
This party is only good if you like sucky parties.
All we've done is talk about your periods and your spotting and your almost pregnancies.
There are so many Asian people in this pool. It's like I haven't seen this since the last tsunami. I mean, this is incredible.
Oh, my. That was a joke.
I don't think your stepdad wants me to leave.
What?
What?
I was just on the slip and slide, and he
And what? He spoke to you?
Well, it was just like the slip and slide wasn't moist enough, and he helped me wet it down.
Okay, get out of here. Get out of here. Get out of here.
Oh, we got to talk to Seth about this. I've been joking around a little bit here, but
He shouldn't be moistening a slip and slide for anybody at this party.
He should not. All right. Danielle, nice to meet you.
Yeah,
Danielle,
bye.
Go fuck yourself.
God, Marissa, come on. You're a 17-year-old girl.
I know. I want to apologize to America because they're seeing an angry side of me. A lot of times when I can't control fully the situation, I get angry.
It's
what
weird
we've been
because
working on a lot with our bat beating techniques.
Danielle is gone now, and I feel like a fog or something has been lifted from me. Like, what was I talking about while she was here?
You were trying to get her in a bad cop scenario, fantasies of yours.
I don't know what.
I know.
I'm sorry. I don't
know
what
it's not your fault. Her tits have magical powers.
Anyway,
that happened. So hopefully she'll leave. Hey, get out of here. I want you out.
I'm just getting some combos.
There's not enough combos for all your Asian friends.
Pain.
Oh, God. So, Listler, wow.
Hey, what's
what
up?
What do you think of all this story? I mean, these
what
revelations.
They're not. Nothing is a revelation to me.
You knew all this?
Absolutely.
Why didn't you tell me? First of all, I've been obsessing over the fact that I didn't have sex with gutter balls at the prom, and you didn't tell me
anything. I told you, I don't want you opening that up for anyone.
I know, but if I had known he hadn't had sex, I wouldn't have went on such an emotional wild ride.
You know what? No one can hold your emotions down, all right? Whatever it's going to be, oh, the price went up on Bugles. You're going to freak out, you know?
That's true. I did have a nervous breakdown in a Ralph's recently about the price of Bugles going up.
Oh, it doesn't matter what it is. You're going to go on a roller coaster.
All right. All right. If you don't mind, I'd like to have Seth come up on the platform and
I'll help him. Seth!
Oh, that's right. By the way.
Hold on a second.
We've talked
here,
about Seth.
Get in this Jimmy.
I can do it. I know how to mount an above pool's platform. I've done it goddamn before. All right, I'm fine.
Hi, Mr. Wampler.
Hello, Aukerman. You know, I got to say real up the top, you know, I don't like you coming around because you work her up into a tizzy. She gets so...
She doesn't start at tizzy?
Goddamn worked up every time you come around.
Hey, Seth. He's not working me up. What's working me up is I just heard you moistened a slipping slide for my mortal enemy, Danielle Bartiromo. Is that true?
Is that the girl with the tiny feet?
The tiny, that's
You're
what you notice about her?
Did you see how small that young girl's feet were?
I don't
Astounding.
Know. Astounding. I couldn't see them. I was standing above her. I was looking down.
My first reaction was everything about her is beautiful except for those horrifyingly, like little Cupid doll feet.
Wow.
And I was like, well, if you come into my office, maybe I can do something about
it. Oh, I'm sure you'd like to do something about
it. Hey, you know what? Hey, I'm very happily married to your mother, and I've taken her name, and that's that.
Yeah,
okay?
And you're about to have a baby, so why don't you start acting
Well,
like
maybe
it?
If you goddamn shut up and she is trying to rest in
now
there.
Now who's working Marissa into a
You don't know what it's like to deal with this on a daily basis. This child is a hurricane, okay? This child is... I mean, I love her. You know that.
And I love you.
Okay, now come here. Oh, boy.
Oh, wow.
Oh,
you,
boy.
You said you loved him on the last... On the,
Did
the,
I?
Yeah, on the yeah. Christmas Wamtacular.
Because it felt like the very first time.
Yeah.
Well, every time you do it, you have that little reaction.
Must be the sugar rush.
Seth, have you ever worked on Diane's feet?
Yeah, I did a little scraping on him. She had some initial bunions that I was trying to get out of there
some
for her.
Some initial bunions.
Yeah, like initially, and then she had some recurrent bunions after that.
Seth, I laugh
because I should have done my job better.
Yeah.
But, you know, that's the industry.
Seth, you see all these Asian people here who have just walked in. I mean, they may be victims of foot binding.
Maybe. I mean...
Have you taken it upon yourself to...
I gave them all a card. I sure did do that.
Oh, I'm sure you did.
And you know what? I used my new Samsung Galaxy. It's got this e-card thing. Oh, I just sort of... I was making my ties. I could move my hand over the front of it.
We are not sponsored by Samsung Galaxy.
But that's a great product.
Hope. No, that's his hope, that he could get on the podcast and get another free Samsung Galaxy
because
your screen cracked.
Yeah. That's another thing about these phones. They really need to upgrade. Can I get closer? They need to make the screens
so you're
better
too close
on these.
To the mic.
On these
Seth, what were you doing
phones?
Talking to.
What's the problem now? It's every single moment. It's like you're giving birth to a devil out of your yuya. And it's just like, it doesn't make any sense to me. Can't you just have one calm moment?
Miss Listler, could you please talk some sense into him?
Listler, the way you're staring at Seth here, it's uncomfortable.
Would you like to adjourn? I've prepared the couch with a plastic tarp.
What? For what?
Just in case.
What? In case what?
In case one of us shit ourselves out of me taking advice from a woman? No,
oh
thank you. No.
You know what?
She's like a sub officer to me.
She's
a
sniper, which I don't think has any kind of ranking.
No, they have ranks. What, you think snipers
think
just
snipers
go around willy-nilly taking orders from no one?
Miss Listler said
God,
they don't. They take orders from their own selves.
To be fair, Aukerman, you don't know what you're talking about. Within the military, the sniper is its own operating
Snipers
unit.
Snipers do whatever they want. This is amazing. How the public doesn't
known,
know about this?
They're known as the most whimsical soldier that you can ever meet.
They're like who's the guy with the long blonde hair in Lord of the Rings?
Fabio.
No, the elf.
Orlando Bloom?
Yeah,
Legolas.
They're like
Legolas.
He has a name that almost should come from The Lord of the Rings, Orlando Bloom. That's like a character name from that movie already.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
He had a leg up on being cast.
Terrific
actor.
So snipers are like the Legolases of the army.
Yeah.
Wouldn't mm-hmm. you say?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
I'm sorry, what did you want to do on a tarp-covered couch with my stepdad?
I don't know. I wasn't planning anything. I just want to be prepared should something happen.
Listen, I don't know what that...
What does that mean?
I sweat a lot in my thighs.
Okay.
Listler and Wampler, you both know have that, some weird thigh action.
You know what that might be a result of? Your toes might be too close to each other.
Okay, we're not doing a consultation
take a look,
right
take
now.
A look. Check,
oh my God, you've got the closest toes I've ever seen. There's Listler, no air that could get between those toes.
And yet she's constantly wearing sandals.
Mandals.
Mandals.
Yeah, man sandals. As opposed to the sandals women wear. Listler, let's talk about your history with Seth just a little bit.
Yeah. Oh boy,
very briefly. You used to stay over at the Wampler condo for a little while on the couch, and then one night you woke up.
One fateful night.
Seth here didn't know you were on the couch. He was. He went to the refrigerator in the middle of the night.
And
nude.
Why shouldn't I be able to? It's my house.
Well, okay, you knew she was staying with us, and yet you were pantsless. Yeah.
Because that's how I sleep. I'm a free spirit, and I'm not going to rummage around through. I don't like the way your mother organizes the drawers, so I'm not going to go rummaging around trying to find the difference between her yoga pants and my pajama pants. Okay.
Right. Yeah.
I put on her yoga pants one time, and it felt like a goddamn fool.
All right. At any
So at any rate, you're in front of the refrigerator. Listler sees your naked buttocks.
Okay.
She says, what did you say?
I didn't say anything.
I thought you said...
She said, turn
around. No, well, when I got up to the refrigerator, I thought when you meant I saw his naked buttocks from the couch.
Okay, you walked up to him and then you said...
Yeah, I said, turn around.
And right. Guess what happened?
He didn't turn around.
I did not do it.
5 hours, frozen in place.
I stood in the doorway of that very, very energy-efficient refrigerator and just wasted cool air and did not move.
And who got tired first? Who backed down?
Listler.
I did walk away eventually.
Yep.
She walked away eventually, but the next morning we found an impression in the Fage yogurt that looked like what looked like to be a white asparagus.
And
but we knew it to be... Seth's erect penis.
No,
green and a white asparagus leave very different impressions.
Yes,
and,
they do.
And we have to I need to say this. A white asparagus was in season. I was getting up to have my midnight snack.
Of a raw asparagus?
Raw asparagus
dipped in yogurt.
Yes.
I get it.
I can't take probiotics.
No,
okay?
Like I said,
my
the
body
last
rejects
time,
them, it actually builds up an enzyme, anti-enzyme, in my intestinal wall.
Snooze.
Which creates a diuretic
point
effect
is,
in me. Okay.
Your phallus might have been erect for 5.5 hours straight. Is that correct? Because of Listler's presence.
Here's the deal. I don't give a shit about you anymore.
Oh,
nope,
boy.
Because
then why
you
did
got
you bring
someone
the tarp?
Else.
Yeah, I mean, to me...
Because it still affects me.
Okay.
All right, he still affects me. I can't get around him without being affected. It's a history. It's a chemical pheromonal thing
and
that
you,
just happened.
Is this returned by you, Seth? Or?
I can't. You know, when you give off what I call sexual gamma rays like I do, I can't be responsible.
Yeah. Sexual gamma rays?
She's like the sexual Hulk here.
Every time she gets around me, don't get her angry or horny because that thing's going to turn green.
Yeah.
She's going to have a green vagina.
You know what? She has somebody new, so she doesn't need you.
And also, that baby might be mine.
What? Oh, let's go to a break.
Wait a minute. It's time for a break.
Oh, is it? Yeah.
We got to go to a break.
Okay. We'll be right back.
Hey, is this a trampoline? Wee! Wee!
It's a one-footed trampoline. He took off right into the pool. That's amazing. All right, well, we'll be right back with more Comedy Bang Bang live from Marissa Wampler's 17th birthday party right after this.
Wop it up!
What's this one?
Another Will Smith classic.
Hey, welcome back, Comedy Bang Bang. This just sounds like ominous synthesizer
music. It's about to kick into some Men in
Black,
really
right?
Amazing rapping.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
All right, can you turn it down? Your mother is trying to sleep.
The galaxy defend us. Gonna womp it up.
Why is Diane trying to sleep in the middle of Wampler's birthday
well,
party?
Well, she's just a couple months out from giving birth. She's
oh, yeah,
and
that's
a stone cold capital B.
Well, no, no.
The galaxy
she gave
defender.
Birth to you, so you can't say that about her. But
I can
she,
do whatever I want.
And womp this is going to be your little brother sister, so you're going to have to come around to that,
wait,
too.
Wait, brother sister meaning both? Or
well, you?
No, we don't know yet. Okay. I mean, with some of the pictures
there was some
were fuzzy.
Testing, yeah.
Indeterminate
there
genitalia.
There were some problems with the testing.
You might have an inverted penis, which could be like a vagina, but we haven't named it yet, so.
You haven't named the inverted penis yet.
Or the thing.
Oh, okay, great.
In her.
It doesn't matter, because I might emancipate myself once this baby comes out and start living with Lister full time.
No.
Here come the womp it up.
All right, just to... How many, hey, real fat. Sweetheart, open your eyes. Open your eyes. You're in public. God damn it, you're in public.
What?
She's at her own birthday party.
I know, but I just need, I have to do a food check. Now, did you eat
what?
Did you eat anything with any kind of stevia or Alestra or any kind of...
All I've had since 8 a.m. this morning is Mai Tai after Mai Tai.
And they're, okay,
I am
to
on
be
a 100%
fair,
liquid diet
sweetheart,
right now.
I got to be honest. I was making some Mai Tais for your party, and I might have mixed up some Mai Tais that I made for myself.
Then I may be 100% wasted.
All right. All right.
So that before happens. The break, we said some very inflammatory things.
Yeah,
I feel like we should follow up.
I guess we do. Now we talked about this a little on the Womptacular or the last time we were on the show. I can't remember.
Yeah, last time.
Listler, you think the baby? I don't even know how this would work. You
this
think Diane's
craziness.
Baby might be your baby?
I'm just saying. I knew from some confidential medical records that I found that.
Where'd you find these?
She's a sniper.
I told you there's easy ways to get there.
She has rabbit warrens all throughout Marina Del Rey.
Yeah.
Okay. Sometimes when you drive over a pothole, you think it's a pothole. That's one of her warrens.
Diane supposedly had a hysterectomy, so I don't know how she's getting pregnant.
Yeah, months after she gave birth to me, she said, take it all out. Not for a medical reason, either.
B.
I don't want it anymore.
She says, I don't want it anymore.
I store secretly my frozen eggs at the same fertility place that they
what
go
do you
to.
Mean secretly? You're not paying by the month for
no,
that?
No, I go in every night and put my eggs into the...
Every
that's a lot
night.
Of
you're
eggs.
Unloading
how
your
many eggs,
every eggs night?
Are you unloading? That's too many eggs.
No, the same eggs.
Wait, you're just taking eggs. The same. You're taking the eggs out and then putting them back. You
that's
take them out
right.
for a drive during the day. What the hell's going on?
I put them in a container with dry ice during the day. I don't like to. I first of all, no one knows they're there.
Well,
and
not
second
now
of all,
they do.
I wouldn't trust them during the day anyway. But at night, while I'm sleeping and I have to get rest, I need to know that they're being cared for.
Okay.
Well, you know what?
So I go crawling through the heating ducts, and I drop them in, and then one day,
always a sniper.
Two eggs were missing.
Whoa. Okay.
And it happened to be the same day that you and Diane came in.
Oh, I see. So we just happened to go in there and take your eggs? Or are you saying it's our fault?
Well, we know they're viable. We know your eggs are viable.
I would not.
100% they're viable.
I would never, never.
She's had no fewer than 13 ectopic pregnancies.
And a son named August.
And a son named, and a half African American son named August.
I don't.
Wilson.
All right, I'm gonna say that
August Wilson Whistler.
A father has a sense of what's going on with the wife. Now I know that this is not.
I want you to test that baby when it comes out.
I don't.
I mean, I guess you'll know if it has a mohawk. It's mine
with frosted tips. If it comes out with a mohawk with frosted tips, you know it's Listler.
If it comes out pre-styled, it's your kid.
But it's your baby and my baby. It would be your and my baby.
And I could finally have a real family.
Hold on. Wait.
It wouldn't be related to you at all. So this would be actually good news for you.
Okay, this is kind of this is a burn on you. I just threw up a little bit in my throat. You ever heard that?
I've never heard that. That's one of your classic burns.
I heard a guy say that.
Hold on. You threw up.
In your throat?
But it didn't come out of your mouth?
No, I swallowed
onto the ground.
It down a little bit. I heard a guy say that the other day, and I was like, that's a great indication of not being comfortable.
The phrase is, I threw up in my mouth.
Do you know that one time?
You didn't throw up in your throat?
One time I caught Seth with a series of flashcards that were human emotions. And he goes through them every morning. Like, and this is what a person
reverse,
looks happy.
On the reverse, it had like a stick figure drawing.
Yes,
of a,
like he has to guess. Happy. Oh, that's right. Sad, frustrated, so he can read people.
All right. To be fair, when I was a child, I grew up in almost sort of like a Sarajevo-like environment.
You grew up in Booton, New Jersey.
I know, but I was left in my crib for days on end without human contact, without any kind of... they would come in, they'd drop the food off, they'd go, we got to go work. I mean, they had to work. I get it.
Believe me, I get it. I'm the one who's living in a crawl space. I should have those flashcards. Too bad I'm so emotionally adept.
Oh, you're not adept, honey. You are clumsy.
Wait, but you know what? I don't care about you anymore because I have a new lover.
He's here.
Yeah,
he's here.
I'm having him zip line in from the corner.
Hey,
over
Kareem.
There.
You know that the condo's not going to allow that. God damn it.
Oh, God.
Oh, he's coming in too fast.
Whoa. My God.
Whoa.
Oh, my God.
God damn it.
Oh, God.
God damn
Ow.
It.
Ow.
That hurt. He hit all of us.
How did you get all? How? My pelvis.
Kareem? Are you okay?
I'm very okay. How are you?
Oh, my God. Were you guys planning that this
Good
whole
to see
time?
You.
I'm helping Miss Lissler with the setup of the stage here, and I saw that this corner over here is available to have a zipline put in.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So we created
suggested it.
Yeah, I got to pay for this bullshit, I am going to be goddamn mad. Because
this is all coming out of the school's budget.
No,
worry.
It is?
Yep.
You don't even work there.
Yep. Exactly.
Anybody.
Do you have a Warren hole into the...
Have access to their QuickBooks.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah.
Anybody can now zipline straight into the pool.
Kareem, can I say that your falafel is delicious?
Oh, thank you very much.
Thanks for setting up that stand. People are really doing
it. It is. Marissa, for you, everything is possible.
God, I love this guy.
Kareem, now, do you sell falafel at your 7-Eleven? We should mention that you and Listler met at your 7-Eleven on a day when Listler
Describe
was...
Describe your meat cute, if you will.
Well, I walked in to fill up a giant igloo cooler with
I
slushy.
Noticed her immediately.
And he said that...
Even though she was wearing... Complete camouflage.
Yeah.
I had on 7-Eleven camouflage, so I had just taped a bunch of chips to my body.
Mm-hmm.
But I saw it immediately.
A couple bags of Sun Chips.
I was like, there is a woman wearing a suit made of potato chips. I want to track her and see what she's up to.
At first, was it you were trying to figure out what she was doing with the Slurpee machine?
She seemed very untrustworthy.
Okay.
Well, then she broke your slushy machine.
Oh, yes.
And you were real pissed. And then we couldn't walk by there for, I don't know, 3 or 4 months.
Mm-hmm.
And then you guys...
I taped a picture from my security camera up behind the cash register to say, beware for this woman.
Beware
she
of
is
this
not good.
Woman
She's
covered
bad,
in chips.
Bad person.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Yeah. And then you guys went on a date.
That's right.
How did that even come about? I can't even... I mean, you have a picture taped of stay away from this woman, then all of a sudden you're on a date? How what happened?
Well, he has a separate... like a... What's it called? That glass that doesn't bullets won't
the
go
partition?
Through.
Partition,
yeah,
bulletproof glass.
Where he usually does this cashiering, which is where the picture is.
Mm-hmm.
And one day I just appeared in there.
You'd gotten in through the air ducts again,
and it spooked him.
Yeah, because this is a place where everything is safe for me.
Yeah, sanctuary.
And then I'm not sure how she got in there. I don't know what happened. It was like, you know, in the Batman movies, when the policeman is talking to Batman, he turns around, the Batman is gone.
It's the
opposite
of
this was like the opposite of this.
Yeah.
I am just sitting there talking to myself. I turn around, and this woman is there.
Mm-hmm. And in 4 questions, I broke through the emotional wall as well, and we were friends again.
Yes.
May I ask what those questions were?
You may not.
Okay.
But if she ever asks them, don't answer them unless you want to fall madly in love with her.
How will I know she's asking
You're not going to know.
You're not going to know.
I had no idea until question number 4. And questions 1 through 3, I'm not even sure if they're relevant.
They're gibberish.
Yeah, but question 4, I immediately, everything
weeping.
Changed for
weeping.
Me.
Oh, okay.
I broke down, begins crying, but also a stirring in my loins.
Okay.
You know,
what happened in that behind that bulletproof glass,
we
may I ask?
Made love.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we made love.
And then we filled out a contract.
Yep.
And we went
on a series. Post-love making.
I didn't have the papers with me, Marissa, and sometimes...
Well, I thought you said you always have to get a signature before you go forward. She I don't want to do any work until you get a signature.
She did make me sign a blank piece of paper.
Yes.
Oh.
But this
and then you Xerox.
This is an example of my trust in her. I knew that she would not use this for ill will.
That's beautiful.
All right. Well, I guess I'll do the introductions. I'm Dr. Seth Wampler. Hello.
Oh, sorry about that.
Somebody's jealous.
Sitting here like a jackass.
Yeah, somebody's jealous.
I'm Scott Aukerman. No, I've been asking you questions. Obviously, you must have heard the podcast.
I feel bad. Because I feel as though I'm being rude, but I've heard all about all of you guys from Listler.
Yes. Oh, so have you listened to the show? You've just
No. I don't listen to computers or anything like this. Yeah. But she's telling me all the time we are together we are eating dinner. She's telling me all about all of you people.
And I get most of my DiGiorno's from that 7-Eleven, so I'm in there 3 or 4 times a day to get my DiGiorno's, my cream cheese.
Hot Pockets.
She's
very...
Pop-Tart.
I keep saying, like, these
the
are going
pockets.
Straight to your thighs.
Yeah,
and she still eats them.
Yeah.
What happened in that 3 months you couldn't get those DiGiorno's? Did you slim down at all? Or?
Yeah, I did.
You looked good for once, and I don't...
Hey, hurtful.
No. What I'm saying is
just trying to encourage you that you could
stop being so fat from down below your waist.
Thanks a lot. You know what, man? I'll take that right into therapy with Listler. I'm going to have to cocoon about that for like 7.5 weeks. Stop being so fat. Kareem says women in Pakistan, it's a sign of great wealth to have thighs that are... 22 times
What else it is also pretty kosher to slam some airplanes into buildings
where he comes from.
9/11, never
this one
forget.
Over here.
All right.
I don't
same all you guys. Everybody wants to come in here.
Oh my God! Hold
on.
I'm so sorry, but I have to take. Can I take the mic with me because I think something's going on?
Yeah. No, okay. Go ahead. Take the wireless with you.
Okay, hold on.
Okay, yeah. Anyway, so
careful on that. Careful going down the.
Instantly started breathing very heavily.
Anytime I move,
Marissa just. Is climbing down the rock wall.
Oh God. Okay. Hold on 1 second. I just saw two people go into the pump room.
The pump room?
Yeah, where they pump all the chlorine from the
Listler,
from the pool.
Listler and I were in there earlier.
Hold on. Creak.
We called it the pump room for a different reason.
Creak.
Which reason would that have been?
She's doing the Listler thing. She's
you don't have to make the noise
Listler.
Of the door as
are you your own Foley artist?
What are you doing?
What are you doing here?
Could you please give us some privacy?
What's going on in here?
What
is going on in here?
Marissa, what's happening down there?
Well, all I see is a crumpled up pair of jams in the corner. And,
jams?
Yeah, and there's, Danielle, and then two Asian girls.
What?
Yes. And, I don't know what was just happening, but I'm freaking out right now.
Eric.
Yeah, Jessica Wampler, why are you doing me here?
Oh my God!
Oh, Jessica Wampler, you're so get out! You're
what
so
is happening?
Lame.
My name is Marissa Wampler! I can't believe this! Okay.
What'd you think her name was? Jessica Wampler? That would be absurd.
I was just invited to this party.
That would be like thinking Eric's name is Jason. That wouldn't make any sense.
Sweetheart. Oh my God, I'm freaking out.
Sweetheart, ask her if she still has the card I gave her.
What?
Card?
Ask her about the card, sweetheart.
What is going on? This is
the That's not
worst
important
thing.
Right now, Seth.
I think it is. That girl's feet is tiny.
Why is everybody laughing? Is it not?
Describe what you're seeing, Marissa, because we are not seeing what you're seeing, and the listener certainly can't either.
Okay. They've made a sort of nest out of towels.
In detail, please, especially when you're speaking of Danielle.
A nest out of towels. Danielle's tits are akimbo.
Akimbo? They're separated
from
each other?
They're flopping to and fro.
What is the shape of them?
They're conical in shape. The nipples look like tiny silver dollars.
They're perfect.
They're perfect. In fact, there's a bright light coming from them. I wish I had brought my sunglasses.
Okay, and there's two Asian girls there as well? What are they doing?
There are two Asian girls. They seem to be attending in some sort of way.
Oh.
Yeah. One of them has a hand towel over their hand as a waiter would. I don't know what happened in here. Gutterballs, how could you do this to me?
Eric, are you down there?
Yeah, I'm here, Scott.
What's going on down there? Some sort of...
Danielle was here, and she said she wanted to talk to me about our breakup. In the pool house. In the pump room, rather.
In the pump room?
In the pump room. So I came in here, and then...
It hurts.
Then what happened, please? And talk slowly.
Kristen and Katie came in with us, and
what kind of names are those for Asian people?
They're American names.
Yeah.
Shut up.
They're probably third generation at this point.
Would anybody like a SMT?
Which one are you? Now, what's your name?
That's Katie. I kissed him.
Okay. And you're serving
Kimmy,
tea down there?
Kimmy has produced from God knows where her gigantic purse what seems to be a tea setting for 11 or 12 people.
Orange blossom is sweet jasmine.
I'll take some tea.
So
you
Eric,
will not have any tea.
Eric.
I would be up ahead a bit.
Eric, why are your jams off?
When we got in here, Danielle said she wanted to see something, and then she took my jams off.
I just wanted to see his jams off.
You know what? Okay, I don't sense. Believe
then
any
she took
of this.
Then she took her top off, and I got a boner, and she said, see, I knew it. You still love me.
Okay. That's it. That's all I needed to hear. I want all of you. I want you
but
out
wait,
of my pool
wait,
party immediately.
But wait, Marissa.
What?
I said I don't.
What?
I said I don't love you. I love someone else. I'm just sexually attracted to you.
Oh, my God.
He did
God.
Say that.
That is one of the most romantic things that anyone has ever said to me.
Wait, I have to clarify. You love someone else. Who are you talking about?
Katie.
What?
He said true. He said, I love you very much, and I said, I love you.
Oh, my goodness. So, Eric, you are burning through the ladies at Marina Del Rey High.
I don't know what's happening anymore. Choctaw, I'm sorry you had to have to see me this way.
You guys want music right now, right, as to underscore this? Just playing just the two of us.
Marissa, I'm not seeing
well, really,
you, by the way.
Really, it should be just the four of us.
There's actually five of you.
Five, with Kimmy, including
Sweetheart,
Kimmy.
Sweetheart, get out of there. If it's a negative environment, get
right,
out of
thank
there
you,
for
Seth.
Yourself.
I'm getting
right?
out of here. I'm getting out of here.
Okay.
Wait, hey, Marissa, wait.
Close the door behind
just
you.
Just get out of here. I hate all of you.
Come on
Let
back up here.
Come on up
get out of here.
I should have to bring a tea up.
Nobody wants
a stupid tea. I'd love a good Jap tea.
Oh, my God.
Oh, dear. Okay. Marissa, come back up here. Use one of the tramps.
Oh, okay.
Get up here quickly.
Okay, I'm here.
Wait, use the water cannon.
Okay.
Whoa!
Whoa!
What? Ow! God damn it.
Oh, you know what? That was actually a really great idea to use the water cannon because I kind of felt like I got reborn there for a second.
You got up here real fast.
I felt a lot
it wasn't
better.
Awkward watching you climb up that thing.
Oh,
yeah.
God.
I'm so sorry, Marissa.
No,
I feel terrible.
You know what? It's better that I saw it because...
Yeah.
I need to understand what's going on. I mean, obviously, Gutterballs is not in any position to be in a relationship,
no.
And I think we knew that.
Can you describe
we
his
did,
mechanical
we knew that.
Pencil?
Well, it was as thin and long as I had remembered.
Yeah.
Excuse me, can I just say something?
I cannot believe
can
how
I just
did you
say
get
something?
Up here?
When we went to the prom, I said to you that I thought we could make a very good couple and that I had real feelings for you.
Oh, boy, here we
and
go.
And then you said that we couldn't be together because you didn't feel that way towards me. And so I went out
what?
And I moved on.
Why did you say that, Marissa?
I declared my love to you and I said I would not go to college so that I could be in town for your last year of high school.
But you got into Marina Del Rey community. Why would you turn that up?
That's what she said.
Turn it down, sweetheart. You turn it down. You don't turn it up.
Whatever.
And you said that I should go and do that and that you didn't love me and you only thought of me as a friend. And so I started going out with Katie Wong.
Why would you say that? We've talked about Eric constantly since your first appearance.
I had been watching obsessively the Kate Hudson movie, How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days.
Oh, okay.
And this was on Charlotte Lisler's recommendation.
You gotta stay away from
film.
That
movie.
I'm with you. That's
film.
I was surprised. I got roped into that one, too.
And I had followed all nine of the steps, and the 10th step was when he professes his love to you to say that you didn't feel the same way, and that's how you would really get it.
I want to take this moment, and I want you guys to face each other, do a couple squats, and then I want you to say to each other what you really feel over this Robin Thicke song. I'm sorry I don't have blurred lines.
Wait, do you need it? I can give it to you.
It's too late. It's too late.
Is this the kind of thing you do at 5:30 in the morning? This sounds more like army training, by the way.
I want you to...
What kind of deep... Are we doing a deep squat, or...
Is there some sort of tire obstacle course that you're supposed to go through as well?
It's a garbage can run.
Do I... Am I spotting one of them, or what?
Sure, get behind your stepdaughter.
All right, I'll get behind her. Sweetheart, you know how much you weigh below your waist, so don't tip back on me.
Should we get Danielle up here as well, or...
I'm here.
Hey!
All right, yeah.
God, you pop up like one of those
How much weight can this thing hold? Let's all be clear about
Katie
this.
Should be here too.
Yeah, how much we really, because we all know how we all how much we all weigh. How much do your boobs weigh? Is
oh,
that possible?
God. To,
just so
what?
We know if this is going to collapse.
I
or not.
Weighed them once on a grocery scale, and they're about 12.5 pounds each.
Yeah, I that's hope like, you wet wiped that grocery scale because that's
couple
disgusting.
Couple bowling balls.
Size
of
a four wet wipes. Balls. I have a wet wipe for you.
I'll which one are you?
I'll take that.
Marissa,
Katie.
I do feel
excuse
like
me,
I should tell you.
Sayonara, I'll take that.
I do feel like I should tell you, Marissa, that even though I feel like you are the love of my life.
Yes.
I have been having a prolonged summer-long three-way with Danielle and Katie.
Okay.
Whoa.
Okay, this is tea. Very hot.
Nobody wants your fucking tea, Kimmy.
Sweetheart, this is Japanese tea. I'm going to take some of this.
Please don't burn your lips, sir.
Thank you so much.
Kimmy?
She's not part of the three-way. She
thank
just
so
serves
much.
Tea during
she's,
it?
She's our tea girl.
Kimmy, she just gives us
arigato.
Tea.
Arigato,
all right.
Domo.
All right, we get it. You spent time overseas.
Yes, I did.
Wow. All right, continue. Please continue with the sharing of the feelings.
Does it feel like the platform's shifting slightly?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Eric, what I want to say to you is that I wasn't ready for you to walk into my life and turn it upside down the way you did. And now that you have, I'm going to be changed forever. And I think it's best for us to sever contact. Starting whoa. Right now.
Oh no.
And
sorry, what kind of tea is this?
I can't, Seth, I am in the middle of an emotional breakthrough.
Oh, sorry, this tea is so good. It is so good.
This platform shouldn't be swaying
guys,
the way that it's swaying.
Guys, I don't feel safe right now, emotionally or physically, on this platform.
This is, well, we've had a...
Wait, everybody should get on the zip line to get out of here.
Okay. Can we zip line up together?
The show's not over yet. I mean, we should wrap it up. We've had a lot of revelations here. This is an emotional show. But before we go... We do have to do our last thing on the show, which is a little something we call plugs.
Jesus,
five, well, four, three, nose, one.
Wop it up!
Plugs.
Here I am on a podcast, too.
Right? Let's womp it up.
Oh, Granny's all upset.
My handful of production of Pippin. I'm ready for my moment.
I've got some money. You've got goods and services. Let's keep this economy going.
MovingOn.org.
Uterus. Ow!
Thick there.
It's been...
Plug.
Stand-up comedy.
Are your plugs done?
I don't have scrotums. I don't have vas deferens. I don't have any of the male parts.
Google it.
Mash.
All right, I'm going to...
That is my favorite plug song
That's
ever...
too long.
Marissa,
I'm
going
to say it is too long.
No,
I lost
not
focus.
Long enough.
Marissa, you brought that one to my attention.
Yes, a fan, one of my fans.
Who did this one?
this was a gentleman named Tim O'Brien. He's okay. At the Stanford School for Music, and you know what? Sounds like he's in love with me, so...
He pieced that together, though.
He
that
pieced
was
that,
found.
That's
found. A real love
song. That's found song.
That's fantastic.
I'd support you finding him.
Thank just, you.
I'll take
thank
I'll
you.
Drive, we'll do it. We'll drive out there.
Thank you.
All right, guys. I want to start with my plugs, if that's okay. First of all, the Comedy Bang Bang Tour, NYC and LA, sold out. Thank you so much. That is so fantastic. The rest of the cities, get on it. Because these tickets are going fast, and thank you so much to NYC and LA. That's very exciting. The Comedy Bang Bang TV show this Friday, 10 p.m. IFC, 9 Central. We have Gillian Jacobs is on the show, as well as Jason Manzoukas, who is a very funny comedian of note.
I have never heard of him, but...
Yeah.
Oh, I see you're very nice.
Shut up, Katie.
Also, this Saturday at Senna Family, we're going to be showing the Comedy Bang Bang musical episode. We're going to be sneak peeking that, and then the cast and writer, Andrew Lloyd Webber, we're all going to be there doing a talk back after that. That is 5 p.m. this Saturday, August 17th. And then Reggie and I will be out at Bumbershoot. We're going to also be showing that musical episode and then doing a talk back after that, so come see us at Bumbershoot. Okay, that's all my plugs. Should we go round robin style? How do you want to do this?
Sure. Well, listener and I can go together.
Okay.
There's a show that not on television yet, but that we're really excited about.
Mm-hmm. You just heard about this.
Just heard about it.
How does a 17-year-old
girl? We go to the upfronts.
Really? We're not invited. But we sit behind the stage.
Do you have a hole into, like a Warren, little rabbit hole into
this
the upstairs?
This happened on a pier, which is easy access.
Yeah. Essentially, we just track whatever Lauren Graham's going to, and then we go to it.
Okay.
But at any rate, this show's going to be on USA. It's going to be called Playing House. Mm-hmm. And there are two stars. I mean, some of the most...
Gifted
and...
When you say gifted, do you mean like the STARS program that you're in?
Yes,
because
yes,
there is,
exactly. Yes,
there's
exactly.
been some debate over whether it's gifted or
they're special. They're special, okay, and yeah. they're gifted. Mm-hmm. And yeah.
I get
Jessica
it.
St. Clair and Lennon Parham, and they're creating a new show called Playin' House on USA, and we can't wait for it.
Right, yeah. They are, quote, gifted, unquote.
They are.
Yeah. Their Twitters are Jessica_St. Clair and... Lennon Parham.
Right.
Those are porn star names.
Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah. And they also, they did some softcore porn, I think, in New Mexico before
They did a show that was softcore porn called BFF.
Yeah.
Actually. What was
yeah,
one of the F's
softcore girl porn.
Stand for?
I just said it.
Best Friends Effing?
Yeah, Best Friends Effing.
Wow.
And they have a Tumblr called Jess and Len.
Wow, that's good. And you're just fans of these two?
Just really
yeah,
fans.
Really big fans. Really big fans. We can't wait for that. It's going to come out sometime, hopefully around like March or something like
that. Okay, that sounds great. Seth, do you have anything you'd like to plug?
I do. Thank you, Scott.
You haven't passed off enough cards to...
Sweetheart, do you want to eat? Do you want to have clothing? Okay, then zip it. First up... Samsung Galaxy, terrific phone.
I do have a crashed screen.
So if
it's not going to happen,
the company wants to send me any prototypes or mock-ups or anything that's in the works,
so you can
in the Galaxy
it?
Family. I'm a great spokesperson.
Okay.
Two, there's a Groupon available for my orthopedic surgery.
How do people
facility.
Get together to? They all know they have fucked up feet. How does that?
You'll know. It'll either come back in thigh sweats if your toes are too close,
or hairy thighs,
or you'll have callousy bunions.
Recurrent corns.
I'll go into that.
Recurrent corn syndrome.
They can give off like a llama-like smell that you can't identify.
Yeah, like a petting zoo. If your house starts to smell like a petting zoo, it's probably the corns that are to blame.
So what that is, the Groupon is a $5 equivalent. So you pay $2 and it's worth $5.
Jesus, wrap it up.
Come on in there. And then another, I'd like to plug a show that I've been enjoying because it's in the medical profession. It's called Children's Hospital.
Oh, yeah.
It's
that's a good one. We had Rob Cordry from that on.
Yeah.
I don't know who that is.
Oh, he's the guy with the clown.
The clown face.
Oh, okay. I was on a show with him.
I did a comedy bang bang with him. You don't listen to any of it, but.
Yeah. Well, I don't like you doing the show. So
I know.
Yeah, okay. All right. Thank you, Seth. Eric.
Just because times are tough right now for this business and this industry, if everybody who's listening to this can subscribe to the Marina Del Rey Chronicle, that would really help me out, especially if you're in my area.
Is that just Marina Del Rey news, though? I mean,
that may not
really be applicable to most people.
If you're hearing this and you live in that area, could you please sign up? Because I would like to be your paper boy.
You're using
meanness and cruelty as a defense mechanism to shield your true emotions.
Whatever. Your dick looks like a tiny piece of string.
Uh-huh. That's funny, actually, sweetie.
Then why do you think about it so much?
Moving on.
Dot org.
Yeah. Don't take my own catchphrase.
Yeah, that's hers. Come on.
That's mine. Come on.
Yeah.
And then also,
to be fair though, you weren't going to say it.
I stopped because I was in such emotional distress.
And then I'm not on Twitter, guys.
Okay. And let's talk to Kareem. Kareem, what do you have to plug?
Well, we are having at the 7-Eleven, we are having a 2-for-1 special on beef jerky.
Ooh, I gotta get in on that.
I've got really good sausage biscuits too.
Any multiple of 2-to-1?
It's also ice cream.
4-to-2, 6-to-3.
Yep, you can. It's also sausage biscuits, and it's also the month of ice cream because it's the summer. Please come in, and you can get as many ice creams as you want for $5.
Okay,
you can take 100 pops for $5 if you want.
If you want.
It seems like a kind of crazy scheme for you.
Oh, well, maybe people will come in and figure it out.
All right.
Before we move
on. I also want to just say one last thing, and this is not exactly a plug, but it is something I want to get out of the way right now.
Sure.
Miss Lisler.
What?
Oh my God, what's happening right now?
And since you've come into my life, this has been the happiest, most beautiful period I have ever experienced.
Shoot you in the face right now.
God.
When my wife was murdered in front of me in my country, I swore to her that I would never fall in love and marry again. I am now willing to go back on that promise.
Oh, is she going to haunt me?
She will never haunt you. She would want me to be happy, is what she said.
But is she a ghost, though?
Could we let this proposal happen? This is the most beautiful thing I've ever experienced.
This needs more info.
I'm not
impressed. I have this ring, and I would like you, Ms. Lisle, to be my wife.
Can we be together in this state?
What does that mean?
What does that mean?
Is it legal for us to be together in this state?
I don't think it is.
What do you mean?
What do you mean? You could marry him?
No, he's a foreigner.
Well, I don't understand.
Legal.
I'm a man.
What?
What? Okay, hold on. We don't have time. We don't have time to pull on this thread.
Hold on.
I want to thank Haley Lear. Haley Lear, who donated $100 to CBB. Thank you so much. And Danielle, what do you want?
Danielle, what do your tits have to plug?
Yeah.
I'm doing the Marina Del Rey dance competition with my Asians. It's Danielle and her Dirty Dynamic dancers. Yeah,
what day is that in time?
Stop writing it down.
It's next Saturday. Come, it'll be so much fun for you.
Oh, we have so much tea for everyone.
Let's close up the plug bag. Here we go. Wait a minute. The vibrations from the closing of the plug bag are causing...
This thing is shifting.
The platform is shifting! Grab a zip line if you can.
Grab my hand! Oh, your tiny feet are drowning!
This has been an Earwolf Media production. Executive producers Jeff Ulrich and Scott Aukerman. For more information, visit earwolf.com.
Earwolf Radio, boom.com. The wolf dead.